Hi, this is Miles Marie, the Soldier of Mary. In this video, I'm going to be looking at whether Garabandal is a continuation of the message of Our Lady of Fatima. Again, as with the previous videos, I begin by saying how quite a few websites and videos are telling us that Garabandal is a continuation of the apparitions of Our Lady at Fatima. In particular, and of interest, is the fact that Fr Gruner, the great apostle of Our Lady's message at Fatima, he says that Garabandal is a continuation of the message of Fatima. And then there is also another significant figure, one of the early bishops in Portugal, or not so early, I guess. He's a bishop of Fatima area during the 70s. And he grew up, he was a local boy growing up in the area in which Fatima is based in Portugal. He grew up there, he became a priest in that diocese, and eventually became the bishop of that area. I think it's called Leira. And he became the bishop there, and he went to visit Conchita, and when he was with Conchita, he had a nice chat with her and agreed and told her, yes, the message of Garabandal is a continuation of the message of Fatima. In fact, he said it's like Fatima brought up to date. Okay, but in this video, I want to look at the key elements of the Fatima message and see to what extent the message of Garabandal concurs with the message of Fatima. So going through the list of the key features of the apparitions at Fatima, the first on the list, devotion to the Immaculate Heart. And again, because Our Lady said so many things at Garabandal, I'm going to focus on the main messages. I'm going to focus on the public messages. And arguably, there are five public messages. Definitely, there are two. There's the two famous ones, the one that is in the first year of the apparitions, 1961. I think it's released in October 1961, October the 18th, I think, 1961. And then there is the message just to Conchita in 1965, which is often called the second message of Garabandal. I think you could argue that there are three other public messages. You could argue that the message that Jacinta and Mary Loli presented following the Night of Screams, and then the second Night of Screams, that those two written and publicly read out messages are also public messages. And I think you could probably say that the final message on the final apparition is also a message, because it goes on quite long. Most of the messages that are overheard by the tape recorder, we only have the children's side of it. We don't hear what Our Lady said. But in this last vision, Conchita shares what Our Lady said to her. And so it's kind of like a last public message. Okay, back to the point. Is the Immaculate Heart mentioned at Garabandal? Well, not really. The Immaculate Heart and devotion to Immaculate Heart is not prominent in any of these five messages of Garabandal, and actually outside of those five messages is not a prominent feature in locutions and things that the children are talking about. For instance, the words Immaculate Heart don't feature at all in She Went in Haste to the Mountain, the three volume edition of the apparitions of Garabandal, or they feature but never linked to Our Lady or what Our Lady is saying about herself or about devotion. And indeed, Father Joaquin Alonso, the greatest scholar of Fatima, he was of the opinion that there was a kind of similarity between Fatima and Garabandal insofar as that there were traditional aspects of the Catholic faith at Garabandal. But he felt that this one was key, that Immaculate Heart was not present at Garabandal. And furthermore, Our Lady at Garabandal never mentions Fatima, or that she's at Garabandal to fulfill Fatima or complete Fatima. At Fatima, Our Lady said she'd come to establish in the world devotion to her Immaculate Heart. At Garabandal, there is no explicit or implicit continuation of that message. So whilst then it's a no on the first one, devotion to the Immaculate Heart, the most key one, I guess. The second one, that Russia will spread her errors, followed by her consecration and then her eventual conversion. Again, The word Russia is never mentioned by Our Lady at Garabandal. In some questions proposed by Father Laffiner to Conchita in 1965, he asks her quite a bit about this subject of Russia being converted, etc. And he says, did Our Lady or Our Lord ever speak to you about the conversion of Russia? And Conchita replies back that the miracle will be there to convert the whole world. And Laffiner says, will Russia be converted? And she replies back, it will also be converted. The whole world's going to be converted. Again, that's the only thing kind of linked to the conversion of Russia. Our Lady, our Blessed Lord, told Conchita that the world would be converted. And so that would be Russia included. But there's no message at Garabandal of the need for Russia to be consecrated. And most definitely, in 1961 to 65, Russia hadn't been consecrated, and Our Lady's request at Fatima definitely had not yet been fulfilled. So that one, that Russia will spread her errors followed by consecration and conversion, well, certainly the conversion of Russia's present, but not linked as it was at Fatima to the consecration of Russia to Our Lady's Immaculate Heart. Instead, the conversion of Russia is linked to the miracle that will occur at Garabandal. That's interesting. So there's a deviation from Fatima there in quite a big way. Okay, the next one. Until then, persecution of the Church, the Holy Father, wars, and the annihilation of nations. And I think a bit like with Akita, it's this one that Garabandal comes into its own. And many people think that the persecution of the Church was a large part of the real third secret of Fatima. People think that the real or the full third secret of Fatima refers to an apostasy within the Church, like we heard at Akita, cardinals opposing cardinals, etc. And the argument is, and this is what Father Nicholas Gruner preaches or preached, and he said that this was also endorsed by Malachi Martin, a bit more about him in a second, Malachi Martin, Father Gruner, and probably this Bishop of Fatima who I mentioned earlier. They think that most likely the third secret corresponds to something like the second or the fifth or the fourth message of Garabandal, the fourth being the one that Conchita receives in 1965. The one that says, you know, many cardinals, bishops, priests are on the road to hell, taking many souls with them. Less and less importance is given to the Blessed Sacrament. That message. A lot of people think that in 1960, Our Lady had said that the message of Fatima should be released. And instead of releasing the message of Fatima, the secret of Fatima, John the 23rd called the Vatican Council. And he said that the secret was not for this time. And so a lot of people argue that when John the 23rd did not like and did not choose to release the secret, Our Lady then appeared and gave the secret. The idea is that you could not stop heaven's plan, and that the secret would be released in one way or another. What's the basis of this? Like I said, Father Gruner said that it was due to Malachi Martin. Now, Malachi Martin deserves a whole video, a whole series of videos. Malachi Martin claims that he was there one day in Castle Gandolfo. Pope John the 23rd was there with a couple of guys, and they were thinking, well, what should we do for the afternoon? And one of the guys there said, well, why not have a look at the old secret of Fatima, get that out of the archives, let's have a look at it, see what it's about. And John the 23rd said, oh yeah, that sounds like a nice idea. So they sent for the secret to be brought through to them, and Malachi Martin said that they opened it and they read it out in his hearing. And so he heard the third secret of Fatima, and he says that it corresponds to the second message of Garabandal. The second message, the one that I'm referring to, many cardinals, bishops, priests are on the road to hell and taking souls with them. He said he heard the third secret, and essentially Garabandal was the same. Now, there are problems with this whole Malachi Martin thing, because Malachi Martin as a character, you know, the deeper you go, the bigger the questions are about this guy. Was he a double agent? Was he involved with the Freemasons? Was he really working for Jews? Was he a Catholic? You know, was he a real Catholic, or was he some kind of storyteller? I know people who met Malachi Martin when he was alive, and they're reliable people, and they told me they had the impression that he was a bit of an old Irish storyteller, and he said things, and it wasn't always true, but he liked the attention, and he was a good storyteller. I don't know, I'm kind of unsure about Malachi Martin, so I think the fact that Fr Gruner and so many others put so much weight on the idea that Malachi Martin says that Garabandal's second message is the third secret of Fatima, I don't think that's conclusive. And in fact, another guy that everyone thinks knew the content of the third secret, Father Joaquin Alonso, who I already mentioned, he did not consider Garabandal to be a continuation of Fatima. And he wrote a book on the third secret, telling us more or less his estimations on what was going to be in the third secret if it was ever released. And he did not think it concurred with the second message of Garabandal. He said Garabandal, as I've already mentioned, it had many traditional aspects of the Catholic faith, mentioning prayer and penance, but he did not see it as a continuation of the message of Fatima. Our Lady Laika de Kita, though, she does talk about a chastisement, and so this kind of falls into the annihilation of nations part, and probably wars, because Our Lady says in the first public message of Garabandal that the cup is filling up and the big chastisement's coming. And then in what you might call the second and third, the little messages after the Knights of Screams, again, they say, look, a big chastisement is coming really soon, and the girls scream all night seeing the coming chastisement. Maybe they saw the fire falling from heaven. Actually, they do say they saw fire falling from heaven. They basically say they saw something like Sister Agnes announced at Akita. And then in 65, in the second publicly released message, as it's known as, Conchita says, now the cup's overflowing. The chastisement is really on its way. Okay, so that kind of means that we do have the third one talking about, even if we can't be certain that the second public message of Garabandal is the third secret, Garabandal does have the idea that there's going to be annihilation of nations, that there's going to be wars, that communism is going to spread again, Russia's errors are going to, you know, they're never going to go away, and there's going to be persecution of the church. So that's definitely there. So I think we'll give a tick for that one, even though there is no message about Russia needing to be consecrated as the way that will end all of these problems. Instead, it seems that all of these problems will end by a miracle. But actually, conversely, weirdly, unlike at Fatima, where Our Lady's saying, look, there's going to be persecutions, but then my Immaculate Heart will triumph, actually, Garabandal puts it in reverse. Garabandal says, according to the official chronology in all the books, that there's going to be a miracle that converts the whole world, then there's going to be a chastisement, which is actually not what Fatima says. Anyway, for the sake of argument, we'll give this one a tick, because enough people like Fr Gruner, like maybe Malachi Martin, like the Bishop of Leira, the one that has now passed away, they all seem to think that there was something in this, so I will give it a tick. Okay, next one. Communion of Reparation on the five first Saturdays. Reparation is mentioned at Garabandal, and the children do receive Holy Communion mystically, but there's no mention of communion of reparation on the five first Saturdays, so we have to give that a cross. Next one, praying the rosary every day. That's definitely going to be a tick at Garabandal, because Our Lady definitely wants you to be praying the rosary every day. She's praying the rosary with the children at Garabandal, and she is encouraging them to pray the rosary. She's calling them to pray the rosary in ecstasy pretty much every day for those, for 2 years, certainly. So praying the rosary every day is a big part of Garabandal message. prayer and penance for the conversion of sinners. Again, this is kind of there at Garabandal. A lot of the public messages, or the messages, they seem to be saying do penance to prevent the chastisement. And again, this is weird about the Garabandal chronology. The children are telling us do penance so the chastisement doesn't come. But, you know, before the chastisement, there's like this big warning when everyone sees the state of their soul and there's a huge miracle that's going to convert the whole world. But do penance so the chastisement doesn't come, which is presumably decades and decades away. But anyway, this is what's come to be the official chronology of Garabandal. And I guess I've got to say I've got problems with it. It doesn't seem to make sense to me. But the children are saying, do prayer, do penance so the chastisement does not come. There's a little bit about prayer and penance to convert sinners insofar as the world is not changing and prayer and penance will get the world to change, and by the world changing the chastisement won't happen. So I think you can say that that is prayer and penance for the conversion of sinners. So I'll give that one a tick also. Now the final one, the Fatima prayer, save us from the fire of hell. Well, it should be mentioned that in the rosary that the children are chanting and saying, they're not actually using the Fatima prayer. I guess it hadn't reached Spain at that point, or it wasn't that commonly said in Spain at that time. That's kind of interesting. But is the message, save us from the fire of hell, a key aspect of the Garabandal message? Well, like I said, in the public messages, hell features talking about the cardinals and priests going to hell and the bishops, but we're not told by Our Lady in that final message that we need to pray so that they do not go to hell. She's kind of just telling us it's a fact. Many are going to hell. She doesn't say, you know, pray for them that they don't go to hell. She does say, you know, you should sacrifice more, think about the passion of Jesus. And she does say, if you ask pardon with your sincere soul, God will pardon you. But not talking about we need to pray for the conversion of these wicked priests, cardinals and bishops. Although the children did do that, they did pray for priests. I think it was Jacinta who in particular was given in her heart a great love of priests and a desire to pray for them. If you search through She Went in Haste to the Mountain, you do not find many mentions of hell, nor the idea that souls are falling into hell and that we need to do prayer and penance to prevent them from falling into hell. That's actually not a huge aspect of the Garabandal apparitions. The Garabandal apparitions are more these children overcome with joy at being with their mother and spending time with her. That's the accent at Garabandal, which is different from the accent at Fatima. At Fatima, Jacinta, Francisco, Lucia, I mean, they're very serious with Our Lady, and Our Lady is very serious with them. There's no sense of Our Lady being there to have a bit of fun with them. But that's very different. Garabandal, Our Lady seems to be there as this loving older sister or this mother that is wanting to spend time with her children and even play with them and laugh with them. So that's why Save Us from the Fire of Hell is not the strong feature of Garabandal. It's a fair thing, but that does mean that it cannot be seen so evidently as a continuation of the message of Fatima. Even if you think Garabandal is a true apparition, saying it's not a continuation of Fatima does not mean that it's not a true apparition. It just means Our Lady is there to make some different points. It's strange that if Our Lady has been telling us about how important the consecration of Russia is, she just decides I'm not going to talk about that anymore at Garabandal, even though I've just told everyone that that really needs to be done for the world to be converted. It's strange that she should change her tune and now say that there's going to be a big miracle that's going to occur that's going to convert the world, and that the chastisements and the persecutions are actually going to come after that miracle, which is a reverse of the Fatima message. So all of that is strange, but I think I could still believe that there is some truth at Garabandal. What's certainly true at Garabandal is, as Father Joaquin Alonso said, Garabandal features all the traditional elements of Catholic faith and piety. You know, Joaquin Alonso, there's no statement saying that he doesn't believe Garabandal is a true apparition, but he is saying, although it's a true apparition, it can't be seen as a continuation of the message of Fatima, but it does not have content in terms of the faith and devotion it's promoting that makes it contrary to the spirit of Fatima. So for me, is Garabandal a continuation of Fatima? I think not. But I do still believe that Our Lady appeared there. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. May Almighty God bless you. May Our Lady intercede for you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.